the 2014 Foot Locker National Championship. You can see no shoving, but a lot of head turning, a lot of looking each direction is where it is. They're gonna try to pick each other up and see where they are.
Once that gun goes off, though, it's almost nice. It's more nerve-wracking starting that warm-up and that hour before the race. How many times are you going to go use the restroom, you know, like making sure you have time to tie your shoes again, all that stuff. It's so nice once the gun goes off, and then you really just show your talent and really show your hard work.
So unlike the girls, the boys are going to kind of stay together here. You can see Osberg there on the left of the way, their direction they're running there. Grant Fisher, our defending champion, right there in fourth there, third or fourth right there running together. All downhill here for the first about 450 meters. Then they'll make that dog loop. They'll jump back up and kind of form into a group as a pack again as they start heading uphill.
You know, let's remind everyone that we do talk a lot about Grant Fisher being the champion. He deserves that chatter that we have. But we have John Dressel, who was second here last year. I know you mentioned this, Tim, but we have our top three guys with Matthew Maton here as well. So to have our top three returning is pretty amazing. But we have an amazing field out here. And like I said, to have this many guys coming back, to have this many underclassmen that are now seniors, it's going to be a fun race today.
It should be interesting. That appears to be Zach Schneider out front pushing the pace, and right behind him there you see Osberg and Fisher.
Let's talk about the record here again. It's an even longer record than the women's. In 1985, Ruben Reyna set the record. His time is 14:36. So it's about a 4:41 mile pace, just for you people that like to really watch the clock. But on the women, on the girls' side today, we saw that clock kind of go out the back door and really get down to racing. And I think we're going to see the same on the men's side with a Grant Fisher in the race, who's not going to be one to push the pace necessarily, even though we know he can. I think it's going to be a sit and kick sort of race today.
It looks like Thomas Pollard took us through that first 800 meters pretty quick there, just a little bit over 2:17. So a very fair pace there. It's interesting that we have so much experience from the West there. They're in those pink jerseys. They're not up front, but they're in that bulk of that group there in that 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 spots. So a good, honest first half mile. They'll go around the pool and come back to the start line area here. Thomas Pollard from Ames, Iowa is our leader right there. Fisher, our defending champion, in second.
Thomas Pollard was 13th here last year, having a great year in the state of Iowa.
There's our four regional champions running 2, 3, 4 right there, 5. So everybody not wanting to lose contact across the road now on a bit of a downhill. Pick Drew Hunter up into that group there. Elijah Armstrong moving up well into that front group there.
Wow, they are flying.
Pick that pace up quite a bit. Now that's a downhill. It's a pretty good downhill here for about 400 meters. And then they'll make the big U-turn and start a little bit uphill heading to the mile mark. We'll get an idea at that mile exactly how fast we're going here.
So are they trying to pick some speed up towards the bottom of that hill to carry them up? At what point do you start thinking about the hill?
Well, you know, downhill running, Grant's a great downhill runner. That's one of the reasons he won that race last year. Downhill running is a skill, and these guys can run faster and be actually more economical and not use up hardly energy. So they learn how to run downhill well. It makes a big advantage. Now you look at them grouping up there. They're still Pollard leading, but there's three regional champions right there. It looks like Fisher and Osberg running right together there. Hunter right on their shoulder, back behind them. They're running 2, 3, 4, and looks like Armstrong. So again, our regional champions, all four running 2, 3, 4, 5.
Now, Tim, you might know this better than me, but I believe there's only been one non-regional winner ever win the Foot Locker National Championship. So, you know, if you win your region, you kind of feel like you're in this group that has a really good shot to win again. But as we talked about in yesterday and over the weekend, a lot of these guys are getting smarter about maybe saving themselves for this race, and they might, you know, be playing a little bit of mind games and not finishing so high up in their region. They're just sneaking their way onto the team, and then usually trying to unleash the beast here.
It's been a lot of fun to watch regionals. They'll start counting places. You know,
yeah.
I mean, there's 10 of us right here. There's 8 of us right here. All right, we can cruise from here. Here we go up the hill the first time. That was 4:42 to the mile, so a fair first mile, 4:42. Pollard continues to lead. There's a little bit of a level stretch here. They'll make that U-turn and head to the top of the road. Boy, Fisher and Osprey, they just look like they're eyeing each other there.
Seeing a lot of green there towards the front.
Boy, last year the West scored 23 points to win, and they have everybody back. So you see that pink kind of moving up as a group, so maybe they've measured themselves well.
What are they thinking right now? I've always wondered. Are they trying to think about it, or are they trying not to think about it?
They're thinking, I made my way up that hill the first time. I only have to do it one more time. But, you know, this is actually a fun part of the course. You have to stay on your feet here, and it's hard to. You're going so fast down that hill. If you guys have not seen it, go over there and see how steep of a downhill this is. And it's dangerous at times, but, you know, they've run the course. They ran it yesterday in actually pretty harsh conditions with the rain that they came out in yesterday. So I'm glad it's drier today for them, but here we go. We see Graham Fisher moving right into the lead here.
Boy, it is great. The course really is in great shape. Yeah. It really is. It's not really affecting the races. So we've got a true race, got beautiful weather, got a great course, got a great cross country race going on here. And again, now that's a group of five right there, but the whole pack right behind them. Nobody's out of this yet. So we'll see if they come by the mile. Somebody's gonna make a move here somewhere here in the next 4 or 5 minutes. Osberg there in the red of the north, trying to push that pace just a little bit. Fisher right on his shoulder in the green. Drew Hunter very comfortable in the blue of the south, the regional champion running right there.
Osberg was 11th here last year. He won his regional by 16 seconds, so a pretty good distance there between first and second on the Northeast region.
Here we go, coming by the halfway point, and our pack's getting larger, not smaller.
Wow.
And all the big players right there. We come by at 7:24. Now, you mentioned the west there, the pink there, now starting to move up. Armstrong leading that little bit of a push.
Yeah, they really did let everyone kind of back in there, didn't they, Tim?
Yeah, it's not a blistering pace, a fair pace, I guess would be the best way to describe it.
Sort of, kind of playing into the hands of those kickers, but how many of these guys have run under 4:07 for the mile? I mean, we have such fast guys in this field. It's not just one that's run a 4:02 or 4:03. We have multiple guys that have run very fast.
You know, I think Adam's going to be right. That hill is going to play a big part in who's going to win this race here as we go up the second time.
Hey, you talk about the competition factor. It's interesting to see the number of leaders we've had so far compared to the girls' race.
Yeah. You know, a lot of times we will see that in one of the two races where someone will try from start to finish. But I think we all knew in this men's race and everyone that's been all over the country chatting about this race, it was going to be an epic race to watch.
Osberg is still our leader, and here he is from Darien in Connecticut. You're not really making a move, but keeping the pace honest out front. Second time through the dog park loop. They're making that U-turn now, starting a little bit of an uphill. Here we go. Osberg, Pollard, Fisher, Armstrong. But our pack now is a pack of nine.
Wow.
Boy, and
5 or 6 green guys out there, Midwest.
The Midwest looking very strong as a team. Just joining the back of that pack, kind of a wild card here, Austin Tamagna, the junior from Brea Olinda. We mentioned earlier he was a national freshman high school record of 4:09. He ran 4:06 last year. Now this year he ran 14:23 to set a new course record at Mount Sac. That's a course been run on over 60 years. Some of the best kids in the country have run there, and he's the new course record holder. So he's certainly capable of running at this pace.
You know, you see Elijah Armstrong creeping up there as well. We haven't talked a whole lot about him, but he mentioned in the video that he loves the hills.
Yeah.
So he's got one big one ahead of him.
Yeah, he's had some fun hobbies. He's a surfer. He likes to be behind the boat on some skis. And, you know, he does a lot of things that actually make him probably a really good runner. And He's been leading that West team, but like I said, they've all been really good friends, and they're all challenging each other, which is kind of fun to see in the sport. A lot of times you see athletes decide, well, it's more fun to win and to maybe be on my own, but these guys are saying, hey, if you're going to make me faster, come on, bring it. Let's see what you can do.
No one's getting lonely here, Tim.
No way. John Dressel there, also one of our pre-meet favorites of you, right there with Tamagno moving up. They continue to move up. Osberg looking over his shoulder. You look over your shoulder and see some pretty fast runners following you right behind. We have now got less than a mile to go to a national championship, and we have got a great field here.
Wow.
Osberg, Fisher, Dressel, Armstrong, Tamagno, Hunter.
Dressel was the one to really push last year, right, Tim? I mean, he was the guy that was leading, and it was all the way down to the wire with he and Grant last year. We'll have to see if he can come back up and push that final 200 like he did last year.
Really a fun race here with the Midwest and the West. They both have three up in that group, and then there's a separation there, but all of them have five scorers, so should be a lot of fun to look at that team score here. But right now, settling in on the individual here, 1,200 meters to go, and it's still anybody's race.
They all look very smooth, very relaxed. Not much tension on their face. Arms are down, shoulders are down.
So if this thing comes down to a sprint at the end, who's the sprinter in the pack?
Well, Fisher's a 402 miler. He's got some speed, but they're all fast. Tamagno's a 154 half miler. Osberg is very fast. It really will. I think who doesn't get killed going up that hill? Who's got a little bit left? Because it's deceiving. You come down off the hill and you think you're almost there, but boy, that was last 600 meters. It's a good bit of uphill there. And then our last finisher, you think it's just 160 meters, but half of that is a good hill. Oh my, look at that pack. Here we go. Osberg, Fisher, Armstrong.
It's hard to sit, too. If one of these guys, they're feeling good, it's hard to figure out when to make that move.
And Hunter, right there. You're talking about the regional champions. They're all right there. Tamagno now moving up into fifth there.
If Grant Fisher pulls off this and is a two-time Foot Locker champion, he will join the likes of Chesrek, Verzbickis, and Ritzenheim.
Boy, there's some names for you to join that club, huh? Here we go, heading up the hill for the second time. Right to left, that's Armstrong, Osberg, and Fisher. Right behind them, Tamagno and Dressel.
Among others.
And I mean, Hunter right there, too. Here we go.
There's 10 of them in that pack.
They're feeling the burn right about now, aren't they?
All right, Stephen, you said about Armstrong liking the hills. They're pushing a little bit of that pace.
They're all feeling the burn, but they're getting pumped here. It's time. Armstrong's moving up.
There you go. Fisher matching them strides. Hunter coming back up there in the blue. Osberg in fourth there. Now we're starting to pick up. There's a little bit level here. Turning and got a little bit of hill here to go.
Now this is different. Fisher didn't do this last year. He's pushing it.
Grant Fisher from Grand Blanc pushing that pace. Armstrong right there in second. It does look like this is the time here. We've decided to make the move. Drew Hunter continues to push back up in there.
Grant Fisher's been undefeated for the last 2 years on the cross-country course.
You know, if he can pull this race off, he really will become one of the great runners in high school history in the country. He really will be a great two-year stretch.
He's such a smooth guy. I mean, even when he's talking, he's not shaken by much, but he also is not overly confident. He's just a very good-natured guy.
Look at that. He is a beautiful downhill runner, pushing that pace, leaning forward here. He has decided if it's going to happen, it's going to happen now. Bottom of the hill. Here we go. Grant Fisher from Michigan trying to push that pace going across the road and continues to open up. He just looked measured the whole way, didn't he? Oh, man, he is pushing it now. Continued just from the top of that hill to the bottom here. Looks like Hunter and Armstrong fighting there for second and third.
When he unleashed it, he unleashed it. I've said it a few times, but, man, he really went for it down that hill. And he has such nice turnover, such knee drive.
He made a clear decision.
Wow. Here he comes, coming across the road here. He's going to be 3 miles at 14:36. Grant Fisher, one of the great high school runners in U.S. history. And he's got more left, charging up that hill. Grant Fisher from Grand Blanc in Michigan Armstrong in second. A great battle in 2, 3, 4, 5. Armstrong. Here comes our Foot Locker, 2014 national champion, defends his championship, Grant Frischer from Grand Blanc High School. And a good finish here, second, third on in. Jesus. All these boys trying to earn All-American status here, our top 15 in the All-American category here.
What an amazing race. I mean, just to sit and kick, but then not to kick from 200 out, to kick from about 600 out and to really just drive home.
It looks like he could have pushed the pace any more if he wanted to. He could have just done anything, couldn't he? We'll get those official results as soon as we can. Grant Fisher's time, 15:02. Holland Hacker, great finish. Moves up to second at 15:11. So a tremendous race there. Hacker really moving up well over that last 150 meters, going from the top 10 to second place there.
Olin Hacker's dad was second at one time, I believe, at this race. Wasn't he back in the 1980s?
Oh, my goodness.
That's a pretty cool story.
Well, a great race by all of these guys, and one of the names there in that top grouping. I don't know if he was, I think he may have been fourth, but talking about Drew Hunter, who is a junior, so he'll be back most likely next year.
That was a great race from him. He really hung in there, looked for a while to go drop out, and at the top of the hill there, he was fighting for second there, so great race from him.
You know, it's tough coming into races when you see all of these athletes have such great pedigree. I mean, they just really, everything about them has... They just are amazing athletes, amazing specimen. And, you know, you have to, even when there's a bunch of seniors, these juniors cannot forget that they are just, they're right there and they have every opportunity to be with them.
Armstrong and Hunter finished 3 and 4.
Well, as we wait for Dina Castor to wait for Grant Fisher to slap some more high fives and perhaps catch his breath, maybe get a little water. He deserves it. Just talk about cross-country runners in general, and it's as if they're all also very, very bright. What is that?
Well, you
good
know.
Good in school, good, you know, good citizens.
Yeah. You know, I think this is a sport where it's pretty neat. You have to dig deep with each other. You have to get to know your teammates. You have to be very, very goal-driven. And if you're not going to, you have to make it in the classroom to be able to make it on the course or on the track. And, you know, I think we are type A individuals, but very good individuals. So it's going to be fun to hear what Grant has to say here.
Let's head down to Dina Castor.
Thank you. What an honor to be on the field again with Grant Fisher, our two-time Foot Locker national champion. Grant, we just have to ask you, how does this feel right now?
This means the world to me. You know, my teammates, everyone back home in Grand Blanc has been supporting me, and they've been, you know, so important to what I've been doing. And, you know, to do this and represent them well, it means so much to me. And it's always great to come back to San Diego and